God damn you! Every single penny you have is about you put at risk because of greed! If you've lost your principles, you've lost your country!
Yeah, no one wants to talk to us, it's kind of a bummer. But, see, we... I mean, part of it's my appearance, obviously. But, you know, you shouldn't judge a man by what he's wearing, right? I'm not asking for it.
If you look, they're all, like, have really clever signs that, you know, make jokes and stuff, and they like to compare the signs and then see who was the most creatively expressive with theirs. So, I guess they were raised by generations that were fighting against, actually, you know, humanitarian conflicts that were taking place in this country. And so they feel somewhat biologically obligated.
I thought they were just here because Trump said grab them by the pussy.
Yeah.
And therefore they're walking around in vagina suits.
Yeah. I kind of wanted to get one of those hats. I thought I would blend in a little better, but then my dad would probably get upset with me.
Yeah, I want to know what When America Was Great, that you want to go back to that.
Well, Make America Great Again is a slogan, and so that's open for someone to interpret. When I interpret Make America Great Again, I don't interpret that as making it great again as a set time period. I interpret that as certain values that have been lost returning. Can you explain what pussy power means?
Women power.
Well, then why didn't you write women power? You're reducing the value of women to their sexual reproductive organs by saying pussy power. Why don't you just say women's power? Why don't you say women's rights?
Why don't you make America great?
It is great.
Let's keep America great.
Well, that's another slogan that he has. Yeah, that is the 2020 slogan. Keep America great.
That you want to go back to.
How is it?
That it was again.
Well, I mean, I think it's still great when I say, like, make America great again.
Again means it's not.
Like I said, it depends on the values that you're assuming whether or not they become great.
What does your
interpretation of the slogan may be different than my interpretation of the slogan. I reiterate, my interpretation.
Who's a rapist?
Bill Clinton.
Okay, blowjob in the White House.
No, settling a civil court with Paula Jones for $800,000 in 1996. That was the rape case. Oh wait, I gotta buy one of those hats. Can I get one of the pink hats?
$10.
It's a pussy hat. Thank you, sir. The duality of man. Yeah, boo Trump! You're the worst. I'm on their side now.
Donald Trump is a
what? Is a what?
Why treasonous little clown?
Why is he treasonous?
Oh, gee. Oh, maybe the treason. Maybe it's the treason.
Which treason? A maggot?
Yeah, the treason with Putin. Every single Trump supporter, all the MAGA hats are now the new KKK cloak. So keep that in mind. When you see someone wearing a MAGA hat and they say, go Trump, what they really mean is Heil Hitler. The only word we use when talking to the Trump supporters is the word no. That's the only word they don't understand and the word they most need to learn. The word is no, Trump supporters. And goddamn you all, Trump supporters. May you burn in hell, Trump supporters. Goddamn you! Every single penny you have is about you put at risk because of greed. If all you are is greed, if you've lost your principles, you've lost your country. And goddamn you all, you'll be penniless immigrants trying to talk your way into Russia because you're that stupidly greedy. You reap what you sow! You reap what you sow! Those 666 marks, they don't wipe off. It's about accountability. When you try to obstruct justice, when you try to deconstruct our country, it's gonna be costly. Every penny of yours, every penny you own, every patent, every copyright, your very citizenship in this country, you've put at risk. Great job! 270 million witnesses we! 270 million pissed off Americans are gonna come to you for every penny you have! Before all is said and done. I'm running for president! Homeless! 2020!
You got my vote.
Thank you.
It was very impassioned. I'm Jewish, am I still a Nazi?
Yeah, if you're part of lying predators Trump Putin, wannabe Hitler Trump, yeah.
We spoke with you earlier. Yeah, everyone's friends here. It's great. We're here with my fellow Nazis from which school?
We go to University of Nebraska-Lincoln, go Big Red. Yes.
Woo! And yeah, I approached him. I was like, what's up, racist? And they're like, what? And because I was shielding my patriotism with the pussy hat that I got for $10. And the guy was hesitant. It's funny because, you know, they're all so anti-capitalist. But then I walked up, I was like, one pussy hat, please. And he was like, all right, what?
What, we're anti-capitalist? Really? That's bullshit.
The left is. Yeah, they're coming. God bless you.
No, actually, vulgar language. Oh, my.
Actually, I'm a socialist.
Be nice.
Socialism is anti-capitalism. Socialism, by definition, is the abolition of capitalism. You know, keep doing what you're doing. To the effect that I respect that they would all come out here in this weather and protest for what they believe in. However, I do think that the people that are out here are very polarized, and like no one's really too happy to see me just based off of the way I look. And that guy over there who's yelling and announcing his presidential run in 2020 started yelling because he saw my hat and called me a Nazi and said that I was supporting the KKK despite, you know, one of my ex-girlfriends being black. I'm somehow like a racist Nazi and everything. So it's like, okay, I mean, I guess if your definition of racism has like devolved into like someone who's wearing a red hat that like is very not anti any race, or just like a racist, like, okay, I feel like we need some objectivity to that definition though at some point. There's a lot of social science studies that have been done that show like people that are told that there's a presence of something but not specifically what that presence is will believe it's there when it even is not. So I feel like that's part of what's going on as far as, oh, we're told racism exists in America. Yeah, of course it does. And then you see someone like me and then you're like, oh, that's him, that's the racist. And it's like, I mean, I guess, like, if it makes you feel better, but you don't know anything about me. I mean, you know that I support Trump, and then you associate that with, oh, he supports Trump, therefore he is a racist, where I don't think that's a good logical leap to make, in my opinion. Maybe I'm biased.
I'm a Republican, and, like, you know, I support my president that I voted for because that's my right, is to vote. And I did that, and, you know, he's in office, and but we're at a march, and it's the Women's March, and I'm a woman. These two are a woman. He can support women as well.
He can identify as a woman. It's 2019.
But we're here to march. We aren't here to march, but we're here to say, hey, we are women. We respect ourselves and, you know, but we also
and we all have
people.
Opinions and we shouldn't
exactly. We shouldn't be treated. We shouldn't be kicked out of anything for our views.
I know that 93% of women in this country believe that men and women should be equal. It's like, of course, but only 18% self-identify as feminist. So obviously women don't believe that that means the same thing anymore. And the question is why? I mean, what purpose is feminism serving anymore? What rights do men have that you do not, that we are still fighting for, I guess would be my question. As far as feminism, by definition being, you know, equality between men and women, of course I support it, but in practice, I guess, as a means to what ends is feminism reaching?
Do you support the ERA being
the
amendment?
I don't know enough about what's the ERA?
The Equal Rights Amendment.
What does that do?
It's that women and men are equal under the law, but it would become an amendment. It's been in question for years and years. It was actually one of the most accepted laws at first, but then one woman who was not a feminist went against it.
Some reciprocity between this. What ways are women not equal under the law that men are?
They're interviewing each other now.
Yeah, I know.
So women are paid less. Women are not accepted as much. I mean, I can go on a whole list. Why do you think that they are equal?
Because they are. I guess, I mean, you say that women are paid less. Did you not know that we have the Equal Pay Act of 1963 that ensures that men and women will be paid equally? JFK signed that into law as a part of his New Frontier legislation.
That doesn't mean it's brought forward, though. You don't have to use it.
Okay, well, so that's always, you know, it's illegal to not pay women the same as men. And they say, well, I know someone that does that. It's like, okay, well, then you should file that with your HR department if you truly believe that you're having disparities, or even the Bureau of Labor will take up the case.
I support Donald Trump because he's actually making moves in his position.
Attaway.
He has taken actions. He is building the wall. He is bettering the human population by taking people out of the United States that shouldn't be here because they're here illegally.
How old are you?
I am 14 and I am proud to be